All right, we've talked about what is a project, what makes a project different from tasks, and what are the three different types of projects in OmniFocus. Now that we've covered that, it's time to actually set up your project. But before we do this, I just want to make one thing really clear. This is a starting point. Because everybody's situation is unique, you do different work than I do, and you do different work from someone else who's taking this course. So the final system workflow, if such a thing exists, that's going to work the best for you is going to be unique to you and different from anybody else's system. But we all need a starting point. So in this lesson, I'm going to show you the project setup, the folder setup in OmniFocus that you should start with. And what I want you to do is use it for a while. Use it for at least 2 weeks, maybe for a month or two, and then see what is working and what is not. Are there still things that you miss? Are there projects that are just getting too big and unwieldy and that you need to break down into other specific projects? Or do you want to maybe introduce some more folders to have a clear organization? Go ahead and make those changes and see how they work. So what we're going for here is incremental improvement. I'm teaching you the starting place from which you can be very productive. But you can improve the system over time based on what you want, what you need, and what works for you. You cannot go from zero to the perfect system. The perfect system doesn't really exist. But what I'm trying to say is you have to start somewhere and you can only improve it by learning. It doesn't help to go sit and mind map for hours and hours and hours to try and come up with the perfect system for you, for the perfect way to set up your OmniFocus projects, to categorize everything. Just start somewhere. And start here with what I'm teaching you in this lesson, and then improve over time. Let me just say that one more time so that we're really clear. You will learn what works for you by doing. So set up the system after this lesson is done. Copy this system into your OmniFocus. Start adding your tasks into projects and creating the one-off projects that you have. And then work with it for a while. Run with it for some time. See what works. See what needs a little tweaking. And then go ahead and tweak that. All right, so with that said, let's go. Now, I'm jumping over to OmniFocus here. And just so you know, I've put my own projects in a folder called Peter's Projects. So you can ignore that. What I want you to focus on is these three folders that I have right here. And really, the two key ones are personal and work. I tend to go on a lot of trips. So I'm separating out the things that are related to my trips in a different folder called trips. But if you want, just go ahead and start with personal and work folders for now. Because for a lot of people, personal projects and work projects are kind of the two big things that they've got going on in their life. So why don't you start here? I'm going to open up the personal folder and show you which projects I have listed in there and why I suggest these as a starting place for you. But first of all, just want to show you how you create a new folder. It's really easy. Just click on the projects perspective and click right here. New folder, and a new folder will show up here. I've set them up already. So first set up a personal folder. I'm gonna open the personal folder by clicking on the icon right here. And if you'll notice, I've set up a list of single action lists, a bunch of them. So these are going to hold tasks that don't merit a project of their own, or at least right now don't merit a project of their own. Below that, I've got some one-off projects. These are all example projects, and these are all example tasks, and I'll get to those in a minute. But this is what I want you to do. Set up that personal folder, have a bunch of single action lists for all the small tasks that don't merit their own projects, and then list your one-off projects. Same thing in work. We're gonna have a couple of single action lists, and then all the one-off projects. But let's get back to personal and go over these single action lists. Now, I've got 8 single action lists. And between these 8 single action lists, they cover all the tasks that I ever get that don't merit their own project. So start with these. And if you find something that really doesn't fit into one of these buckets, you can go ahead and click new project by right clicking on personal and call it single actions. Make this another single action list and put it all the way at the top. Or if you want to, you can call it miscellaneous. I don't think you're going to need it because I find that all the tasks are covered by these other 8 single action lists, but that's up to you. So let's go through these one by one, and I'll tell you what sorts of tasks go in there. So first, I like to have an admin single action list. This is for short admin tasks that don't merit a full-blown project. For example, every now and then, I scan and shred important snail mail, like tax documents I get or insurance policies or whatever. I tend to do this in one go, so I tend to scan them and then immediately chuck the actual paper into the shredder, or at least in a bag to have them go shredded later. So to me, I don't want to break this down into multiple sub-steps because I'm not, you know, I'm likely to do this at once. Another example of a task that you might have under your admin single action list is inform insurance company that you moved to a different town. You know, your insurance company needs to have your current address. Simple task, get on the phone with them. You could even say, call insurance company to let them know. So that's the sort of thing that I have under admin. And so the way this is going to work is because this is a single action list, this will never be done. You'll never be done with admin tasks, right? Unfortunately, for the rest of your life, you're going to have admin tasks. This is unfortunate, but that's the way it is. So anytime you have a new admin task, you know, for example, you're adding it in quick entry, right? You can just go ahead and say, call electrician problem. And you can go ahead over here to project and you start typing admin, and admin will show up. Personal admin. Again, ignore the Peters project. Personal admin. You can go ahead and click that and it'll be in there. If I go save, there we go. It's going to delete that task again. So that's where your admin tasks go. Next up, finances. So under finances, these are your personal finances, not your work finances. If you have your own business, these are your personal finances. I tend to put things such as cancel my membership to a certain app. You know, sometimes you tried an app for a while and it's nice, but you want to make sure that you know you're not paying for things that you're not using, so you got to cancel it. Often what I'll do too is if I sign up for a free trial just to check out an app, right when I'm signing up for the free trial, I'll add a task that says cancel membership to XYZ app ? And let's say the free trial runs out on March 29th, yeah? I'll put March 28th as the due date. And so what happens is, as we're coming up to March 28th, OmniFocus will remind me, hey, should I cancel the membership to this app? I don't know this right now because I'm evaluating this app for a couple weeks, right? So I don't know right now whether I'm going to want to sort of cancel my membership so that I don't get charged at all after the free trial, or whether I'm going to want to keep it. I don't know right now. I could even defer by 1 week because I want to give it at least 1 week to make a decision so it gets grayed out and doesn't get in my way. So this is how I like to do it. And that's the sort of thing that I put under finances. Then next up is the single action list called fun. For example, sign up for a cooking workshop. Add a new locomotive to your model railroad if you're into model railroading, right? Anything that sounds fun to you, put it in here. Now, it's possible that some of these things will become actual projects with more than one step, right? So for example, sign up for a cooking workshop. If you don't already have a cooking workshop in mind, that actually might take several steps. So remember, the way to convert a task to an actual one-off project is by hitting Command-Shift-1. So I just did that, and now it's a project. I'm going to drag that over under personal. And again, I like to have all my single action lists at the top and my one-off project at the bottom. Now sign up for a cooking workshop. That actually probably has to happen in a certain order, so I'm going to go ahead and make this a sequential project. And as you know, I like to click Complete with Last Action. All right, let's start with research all cooking workshops in our town. Propose one to my girlfriend. Waiting for girlfriend to get back to me. And call regarding availability. All right. Transfer the funds. Maybe that's the steps that are needed for a cooking workshop. Notice the waiting for tag here. We're talking about that in a different lesson. So that's the sort of thing that might be under fun. And the reason that you have a bunch of single action lists here is just to start. So some tasks don't need to be their own project, so you put them in one of the single action lists, and it's nice and organized this way. Some tasks may end up becoming a project, just like signing up for a cooking workshop just did. You can go ahead and convert those to a project and put it under personal right here. So this way, you can easily see all of the things related to one area of your life. If you're like, I really want to spend some time getting my finances in order, great, you go here. And it just helps you be more focused. Right, so we've done fun. Next up, I recommend having a health single action list. I like to meditate every day, so one of my tasks in here is meditate for 20 minutes. This is actually a repeating task for me because I like to do it every day. And we'll talk about repeating tasks in a future lesson. And you might also put things like make an appointment for a vaccination booster or like take the kids to the doctor. So stuff like that goes in health. Now, next up, home. And I find that this is a single action list where I have quite a lot of tasks. So for me, this is a candidate for breaking down into sub projects, although right now it's manageable, but maybe. Stuff like buying groceries, testing the fire alarm, cleaning the floor, anything that you've got going on in your home, put those single tasks right in here. Then learning. For example, I recently took an online course on shooting videos with a smartphone. So I might put that as a task in my learning single action list. Or read a book on growing bonsai trees. For a while, I thought I really wanted to learn how to grow bonsai trees. I guess I still do. It's just not a priority. But that's the sort of stuff you can put under learning. All right. These last two are a little different. Relationships is a single action list for anything that you're doing for or with other people. So, for example, if I want to have some drinks with Bob and I want to remind myself to schedule that, I'll just add a task, schedule drinks with Bob. Or if Sarah asked me to introduce her to Kyle, then I might list that as a task right here under my relationships project. So this is cool because it helps you remember what you're doing with or for other people. I like to separate that out into a single, into a separate single action list. So for example, schedule drinks with Bob, maybe that's fun, right? Or maybe that's about finances, I don't know. But I still like to separate that into a relationship single action list because sometimes I'm just in the mood of, hey, I just want to get back to all of these people. I've been taking too long to respond to people who have reached out to me. Let's take half an hour and respond to everybody. And then I can pop over into my relationships single action list and just go ahead and do all of those things at once. So that's why. Now, this final single action list under personal is one that I really like. Have you ever forgotten a birthday? Well, that's not going to happen to you again. Under wishes, I have lots of tasks for all the people in my life whose birthday I definitely don't want to miss or whose anniversary I definitely don't want to miss. And what I do is I add a task, and I highly recommend that you do this the exact same way, is say, wish my dad a happy birthday. So my dad's birthday is May 18th. So I've got a task over here that tells me to wish him a happy birthday. I probably won't forget about this, but just in case, it's nice to have an OmniFocus task. I will defer this task until the actual date of his birthday. Doesn't make sense to see this task earlier. And I will also make it due on the actual day of his birthday, right? Probably you might want to even make it due at like noon or something like that, right? And you can make these repeating tasks. And again, we'll talk about repeating tasks in a future lesson. I also want to make sure I get my dad a birthday gift. So let's say because his birthday is May 18th, that's due on May 17th. And I can probably start thinking about that on May 1st, something like that. So this is an excellent way to never forget birthdays again. And what I do is I just have a long list in here for all the people in my life whose birthday I definitely don't want to miss. So no more relying on Facebook to tell you whether any of your friends have birthdays today, right? OmniFocus is going to remind you, and it's going to remind you ahead of time to buy them a gift if you set it up this way as well. So after the single action list under personal, we now have our one-off projects. So I've got some example one-off projects here just to show you. For example, I really want to learn how to go lead climbing. So I have a project that says learn to lead climb. I haven't filled in the steps here because it's not super relevant right now, but that's what you might do. And you might want this to complete with last action too. So anything that maybe it started off, any tasks that started off in a single action list, but now you realize should actually be a project because there's more than one step to it, and you may not do all of those steps at the same time, turn it into a project. Use the keyboard shortcut, Command-Shift-1, turn it into a project, drag it under personal, and that's where it is. And again, I like to have these underneath the single action list because these single action lists are going to stay here indefinitely, right? Whereas the one-off projects that you have are going to be changing over time. You're going to complete them, new ones are going to show up. So this is kind of visually going to be changing all the time as you create new projects, check off projects, but these ones are going to stick around. So I like to have these single action lists at the top just so it's visually more constant. And what I also like to do sometimes is just drag up a project that's higher priority. So if I think I'll probably do this project, sign up for a cooking workshop before I learn how to lead climb, I like to drag it up here, just as a visual reminder that I'll probably work on this first. That's optional, but I like to do it that way. So some other examples, rent a new apartment could be a one-off personal project, or clean the house before your family visits could be a one-off personal project. In this project, I've set a due date for the entire project. Just select the project, put the due date right here, and it applies to every task inside the project. I haven't added any tasks right now, but you get the point. So that's how I recommend you set up your personal folder. Now let's talk about the work folder. In the work folder, I like to keep things more simple. And this is geared for those of you who work at a company, who work for someone else. If you work for yourself, you might have, instead of work, you might have a business folder. And that business folder may have all sorts of single action lists, very similar to your personal ones maybe, for the things that you do for your business. But for people who work in corporate, you know, work at a company, typically you'll need fewer single action lists. But the ones that I really do think you want to have are work admin and work relationships. So a single action list for your work admin tasks might include reporting your hours worked for the week. Probably filing your VAT taxes is not, that's going to apply to business people and not to people working in corporate, right? But you might say schedule monthly check-in call with the boss. That could be a repeating task, something that you do every month. And again, we'll talk about repeating tasks later, but that's sort of like work admin, right? And then you'll have work relationships. If you know what you're doing at work, relationships are important. You don't just want to deliver good work. You also want to get along with people and have people at least be convinced that you're doing good work. So schedule coffee with a coworker, recommend one person's work to someone else. That's the sort of thing that I would put under the work relationship single action list. Again, you're never going to be done building relationships with people. You're never going to be done with work admin. That's why these are single action lists. But probably you're going to have a lot more one-off projects at work, right? So for example, let's say you want to apply for a promotion at work. Go ahead and make that a one-off project under work and list all the steps that you think you need to take to be able to apply for a promotion. Or maybe you have to write a quarterly report. Go ahead and make that a one-off project under the work folder. I think you see how this works. So again, you'll probably have lots and lots and lots of one-off projects at work, especially if you're really busy at work, and maybe that's where the most movement is in your OmniFocus, if you're primarily using OmniFocus for work. So create those one-off projects, see what works and what doesn't. Maybe you'll need to create, or you'll want to create, more subfolders under work. So let's say you have different clients, right? You can create over here, you can create a new folder under work, client A, and you list all your client A projects over there. I then like to drag it like this below my single action projects, right? Or maybe you could even have it over here, and you can have a new folder for client B as well, and have all the projects for that client live under there. You're gonna have to experiment with this a little bit depending on your unique work situation. But this is the basic setup. Now, like I said, I like to go on a lot of trips, and because I like to go on a lot of trips, I have a separate folder at the top level for trips. So for example, you may be going to a conference. So you have a project for all the things that you want to do before or during the conference. I like to go diving. Maybe I'll go diving in Egypt again, as I've done before. Fun destination to dive, by the way. Highly recommended, the Red Sea. So I'll have a project for that. And I'd also like to hike Kilimanjaro at some point. I don't put these under personal, like I could have put, you know, trips under personal, but because I am usually planning multiple trips at once, it just gets really cluttered. I would have to put all those one-off projects underneath here. It just gets really cluttered. That's why I separated out trips into a top-level folder. So I hope now you understand why it is so important that you start with this setup that I'm teaching you right here in this lesson, and that you incrementally improve it over time. Because you're going to discover that some projects are just bulging with tasks and other ones barely have any tasks at all. So tweak as needed. Now, that was the basic project and folder setup in OmniFocus that I want you to go ahead and start with. So set that up in your own OmniFocus before moving on to the next lesson. And have fun.